Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the arrival of Darren and Ben. And to witness their marriage vows. They would also like to recognise all of those who could not be here today, in particular Darren's dad, Michael, as he is certainly missed but not forgotten. He's in our thoughts and our memories. May I first introduce my colleague, Andrea Kelly, who is the registrar today. It's her duty to ensure that all the legal requirements for marriage are met and to record the marriage of Darren and Ben in the official marriage register. I'd just like to say you struck lucky because she's got a lovely handwriting. My name is Jill Furtado and I'm one of the Deputy Superintendent Registrars in Buckinghamshire. And both Andrew and I are delighted to be here today. It's a privilege and a pleasure to be conducting the ceremony. The change in marriage laws in 1994 resulted in couples being able to choose venues such as Horwood House for their marriage ceremonies. So I'm sure you'll agree that Horwood House provides a wonderful setting for a marriage. And before we begin, I'd just like to tell you a little bit about our surroundings. Firstly, the house is not quite as old as it appears to be. It was built in 1911 for a wealthy Irish businessman, Frederick Denny, who insisted that the house look well established on completion. He was ahead of his time with recycling, really. The old rustic bricks were imported from the Netherlands. Leaded windows and reclaimed tiles were all used to give the appearance of a much older building than it actually is. As you can imagine, life was very different in those days, and an army of servants was employed to run the house. The first child to be born at Horwood House was to the head gardener and his wife, Mr. and Mrs. Thrower. Now, looking around, I think some of you, not many, but some of you may be old enough to remember the Blue Peter Gardener from the 70s, Percy Thrower. This is where he was born. For those of you who are far too young, Percy Thrower was the first celebrity gardener, the forerunner to Alan Titchmarsh, the Monty Don. The Dennys sold the house and the farmland in the 1940s in various lots, and you might be interested to know the house and gardens were sold at auction for the princely sum of £20,000. So if you get the chance today to admire this lovely house, and especially its beautiful gardens, do please take the opportunity. Ladies and gentlemen, before the marriage ceremony takes place, I have to address you with the rather formal words. This place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned by law for the celebration of marriage. You are here today to witness the joining of marriage of Darren Stuart Cliff and Benjamin Francis Alecknam. If any person here present knows of any lawful reason why this marriage should not be entered into, they should declare it now. I'll take that as enough. I think we're safe to proceed. Ladies and gentlemen, we are all gathered here today to witness the marriage of Darren and Lynn and to celebrate their vows of matrimony. This day is very special to them. The vows that they are about to make will not only give each of their individual lives a new sense of commitment, strength and purpose, but will also unite them as they embark on this special journey and relationship together. Darren and Ben, marriage is the desire of two people to share their lives and their experiences with each other, with a willingness to accept each other for who they are. It's about commitment, cooperation, friendship and mutual respect, working together through the everyday tasks and challenges of life. It calls for honesty and patience, and of course, I can say after many years of marriage myself, a sense of humour helps. Ladies and gentlemen, Darren and Ben have found in each other happiness, fulfilment and love. Darren and Ben, today you have chosen to publicly affirm the commitment and dedication to the strength of your relationship by offering each other the security that comes from legally binding vows, sincerely made and faithfully kept. I'm going to get you to do a bit of work now, so if I ask you to stand. And do you freely and willingly enter into marriage today with Benjamin Francis Elton?
I do.
Good answer. And what is your full name?
Benjamin Francis Elton.
And do you freely and willingly enter into marriage today with Darren Stewart?
I do.
Perfect. That's a relief. Darren and Ben, today you will exchange vows which will unite you as a married couple. These words are a formal and public pledge of your love and a promise of lifelong dedication to each other. However, before you're joined in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the vows that you're about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. I'm now going to ask each of you in turn to declare that you do not know of any legal reason why you may not be married to each other. So please will you repeat the following words after me? I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare
that I know not.
That I know not
of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Darren Stewart Cliff.
Why I, Darren Stewart Cliff.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Benjamin Francis Elton.
To Benjamin Francis Elton.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare
that I know not of any lawful impediment.
I know not of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Benjamin Francis Elekno.
Why I, Benjamin Francis Elekno.
May not be joined in matrimony to Darren Stewart Cliff.
May not be joined in matrimony to Darren Stewart Cliff.
A little rest now.
Lovely view from up here. You look fabulous. Destiny. Destiny is a mysterious thing. No matter what you do or where you go, you cannot avoid it. And no matter how hard you try, even putting forth your greatest effort, you can't force it to happen before it's time. This occasion we witness today is the destiny of two souls. There is not force in the universe that could have kept you apart. And there is nothing they could have done to come together sooner. Each of you had to live your lives, lives that were stepping stones that have led to this moment. This uniting of hearts and minds that shall be forevermore. This occasion we celebrate today is the destiny of two souls. Yes, destiny is a marvellous and mysterious thing.
Well, thank you, Val. I think that deserves a round. Marriage is where each partner cares for the other and supports them in all that they do. You're making a statement to each other and to all those around you of the love, friendship and support that you wish to share for the rest of your lives. Marriage is a balance between closeness and space. It's a partnership in which you may each grow to be part of the other, whilst at the same time respecting the other as an individual. Today you will pledge to each other not only your love, but also the strength, warmth and most importantly the joy of true friendship, as you make your marriage vows before us all, your witnesses, family and friends. I'll get you to stand. Who gives Darren and Ben to be married to each other?
We do.
We do.
Could you please step forward and pass your son's hands over to their chosen partner to symbolically join their lives together and unite your two families? Darren and Ben, please turn to face each other. These are perhaps the most important words you will ever say to each other. So especially speak to each other and not to me. Will you now pledge your vows in marriage to each other by repeating these words after me? So join up, Darren. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Darren Stewart Cliff.
To witness that I, Darren Stewart Cliff.
Do take thee, Benjamin Francis Alecno.
Do take thee, Benjamin Francis Alecno.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Benjamin Francis Alecno.
To witness that I, Benjamin Francis Alecno.
Do take thee, Darren Stewart Cliff.
Do take thee, Darren Stewart Cliff.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Ladies and gentlemen, Darren and Ben have also written some very personal vows, which they will now say to each other.
From the moment we met, I knew that someone very special had entered my life. And 20 years later, you still make me the happiest person on the planet. Today, as we tie the knot, I look forward to sharing the rest of my life with you. I will refrain from switching off every device, even when it's not in use. But above all, I promise to cherish, love and care for you, always. And I will never take you for granted, Ben. And I will be your partner and friend for life.
Follow that then.
I cherish you and the relationship we have. You're always there to support me in good times and bad. We've achieved so much, and now I look forward to the journey of our married life together. I will let you win the occasional argument, even when I'm right. But above all, I promise to support you with love and friendship. I will never take you for granted, and I will be your partner and friend for life.
Would you like to take a seat? It has become a tradition in this country for a marriage to be sealed by the exchanging of rings. The wedding ring is the unbroken circle, symbolising unending and everlasting love. It is the outward sign of the lifelong promise that you have made to each other. I would like to ask Alison. And a very special guest to come forward to present the ring.
Help him. Carrying the ring.
I knew that was coming, but I didn't know. I'd like you to stand. That's Paul to come forward around the side. And so, Darren, if you'd like to hold Ben's ring. They are in there, aren't they?
They are in there, yeah.
Could be the orcs.
Yeah.
So, Darren, if you'd like to hold Ben's ring on the tip of his wedding ring finger and repeat after me. Ben, I give you this ring.
Ben, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And as a symbol of our marriage.
And as a symbol of our marriage. That one, is that sure? Sure it's not my one? Yes, it's on.
That's not going anywhere. Okay, could you come around this side? If Darren's not today. So Ben, if you'd like to hold Darren's ring on the tip of his wedding ring finger and repeat after me. Darren, I give you this ring.
Darren, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love.
A sign of my love.
And as a symbol of our marriage.
And as a symbol of our marriage.
Darren and Ben have chosen a second reading today, which Lynn is going to read. So Lynn, if I could get you to come forward and introduce your piece.
Hello everybody. I know you're all going to agree with me. Is it or is it not about time? Sorry.
Yes.
Okay, this is about soulmates. A soulmate is someone who has locks that fit keys. And keys to fit our locks. When we feel safe enough to open the locks, our truest selves step out and we can be completely and honestly who we are. We can be loved for who we are and not for who we're pretending to be. Each unveils the best part of the other. No matter what else goes wrong around us, with that one person we're safe in our own paradise. Our soulmate is someone who shares our deepest longings, our sense of direction. When we're two balloons and together our direction is up, chances are we found the right person. Our soulmate is the one who makes life come to life.
Darren and Ben, today's the beginning of a new chapter in your life, as you've both made the declarations prescribed by law and have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your friends and witnesses gathered here. The vows you've made to each other are a formal and public pledge of your love. Remember what brought you together